Hello friends, today in this tutorial I will be telling you that how to auto deploy your Vue.js app to Heroku platform using GitHub. So you have seen this Heroku platform here. This is a nice platform for all developers which are using technologies such as Node.js, Vue.js, React.js. So we will be deploying this application to Heroku. This is totally free. You need not have to pay anything. So for the trial version, so you need to just create your simple account. I have already created this. So when you land on this dashboard, you will be landing on this. You can create a new app from this menu here. But first of all, we need to create our Vue.js app. I have already created Vue.js app by invoking this command, which is very simple. Vue create and then your app name. So my app name is test project. So I have already executed this command. And for the step-by-step instruction, in the video description, I have given my blog link. This is my step-by-step instruction block. You can follow here. All the commands are there and all the source code is also given with screenshot. So you can go to the video description and you can follow the blog with the video. So let's get started. So the very first thing that we need to do is that inside this project, Vue.js project, before deployment, you need to build this project. So if you open the package.json file of this project, you will find this command which is build. So basically you need to run this command inside the command prompt of this directory. So you will just write here npm run and then you will write build. So basically with the help of this command, it will create this dist folder in the left hand side in the root of your project. And then we will be deploying this to GitHub. And then it will automatically deploy to Heroku. So it will take some time and it will build it for the production. So just wait. I will be back whenever this command is over. Now guys, you can see that the command is successful. So it has created the dist folder. In the left hand side, you will see all the static assets will be present inside this dist folder. So after making this dist folder, if you follow the block, I have given the step-by-step instruction. You need to install these two dependencies, this express and serve static. So serve static is this dependency and express will be the server. So right here inside this directory, you need to execute this command npm I express and then the second dependency is serve static. So you need to install these two dependencies. So I have already installed it. So after this, you need to make a file inside your root of the project which will be serving as the express server. So just make this file as server.js. So just make this file and you need to go to the blog, my blog, and I have provided the code here. You need to copy paste this code, click on the copy option and paste it here in this file. So paste the code here. So basically this will take this dist folder. You can see that I have provided this link, this path here, /dist, and it will start this server on the port number 8080. So now in order to start this, you need to go to package.json and here inside this, you need to make a start script. You need to write this and node and then the file name which is server.js. So this is we are doing this because for Heroku to automatically start our application, that is why we are doing it. If you want to start it locally, you can also do this by node server.js. So if you execute this command, you will see app is listening on port 8080. So if I go to this port number, you will see your app will be live here, localhost 8080. You will see this is your Vue.js app which is live here. So you can run this by locally. Now we will be deploying it to Heroku. For deployment purposes, we have added this command here, start command, which will be used by Heroku to start our application. Now the next step comes is that if you drag down, you will see after adding this, you need to deploy this code to GitHub. So now you need to, this is a very important step. Without it, you will not be able to deploy it to Heroku. So now go to your GitHub. You need to be having a GitHub account. So just sign up if you don't have. Click on the new option and you need to invoke this Vue test project. Let me create this repository name and let me provide a brief description. This is a Vue test project deployed on Heroku. And let me also have initialize this, sorry, just click on create repository. So if I create this, you will see, let me also have a readme file also. So just you need to click this option and let me repeat this process, view, test project. So readme files are very much important if you have to provide. So it is telling me that it already exists. So view test project 123. So this is a test view project deployed on Heroku. So you check this option, initialize this repository with readme, and then click on create repository. Now it will create your repository with this readme file. And now what we want is that you need to deploy your code. So you will follow these commands here, which are given inside my blog here. So stop the server, and first of all, git add dash. So this will add all your files, and then you need to commit, git commit dash m. This will be first commit. Oh, sorry, let me execute this command once again. Commit. Enter. So this is nothing to commit. Now you need to paste your this command, which is git remote add origin, and then it will be having your GitHub URL. So basically this is your URL. You need to copy this and again paste it here. And one thing you need to do is that in the last, add git git. That's it. After doing this, you also need to push the code. Lastly, just copy this command, git push dash f origin master. So copy this and paste it, and now it will execute. After executing it, it will deploy your code to GitHub. So this will take some time, so just wait. It is doing that now. If you refresh it, your code will be deployed. If you refresh, you will see this is your Vue.js app, and this contains this readme file. It will be automatically generated for you by Vue. And now we need to deploy this to Heroku. So now you need to go to Heroku.com and create a new app. Click on this option, new option. And let me provide an app name, that is Vue test app. So it is not available. So 123. So it is available. You can see. Click on create app option. And now you need to link your GitHub account. So this is very easy. You need to select this option, deployment method to be GitHub. And now you need to search for your repository. So basically it will ask for the option to connect your GitHub account. I have given inside this screenshot. So basically it will ask for the permission. You need to grant this permission like this. So it will ask for the very first time. I have already granted this, so that is why it is not showing me. So now you need to search for your repository name. So this is Vue test project 123. And now if you go to search for this, let me search all the repository which are starting with Vue. So this is my repository. You need to click on the connect option. So it is connecting it. Now you can see that it is already connected to this. So we can see which branch we need to deploy. So only one branch is present. This is the master branch. And this is the option that you need to enable this automatic deploys. So you need to enable this option. Let me take this screenshot because I need to use it inside my blog. So you need to click this option here, enable automatic deploys. So click this option. So this is very important. Click this option, and after that you need to deploy this. Where is the option? This is the option here, deploy branch. So let me also take this screenshot. So now for the very first time, you need to manually click on this option, deploy branch. But as you make changes to this application, it will automatically redeploy for you. So now you can see that it is installing the dependencies. So now it will take some time, and after that it will give you the link of your Heroku app. So just wait, it is doing this process. And it is building up for the production also. So just wait. For the very first time, it will take some time, but as you make changes inside your GitHub code, it will not take time. It will automatically deploy your code with the changes that you have made. So just wait. So now build succeeded. So it is compressing it. So just wait. Done. So it is launching your application. So now you can see that it has given this link to you. Your app was successfully deployed. This is the option. Now if I click the view option, this is our app here. If I open this, you will see this is our Vue.js app successfully deployed to Heroku. So in this way, guys, you can simply deploy the Heroku app. And for the, if you make any sort of changes, let's suppose, now let me show you the magic of Heroku. Let's suppose I go to my project inside the public folder, inside the source folder. If I make any sort of changes, let's suppose I change this text to welcome to our Vue test app made by Gautam. I have made this change. Now we need to replicate this change inside our Heroku platform. If I refresh it, you will not see this change. For this change to happen, you need to redeploy your code to GitHub. So for that, we will again make a change. The second commit, we will commit our code. So it is, we again need to add all the files and then we need to execute this. So you can see that one file changed. So now we have made a insertion process in one file. So it is telling to me that one file changed. Now we need to push the code to GitHub. So git push dash f origin master. Execute this command. So now basically it will push the changes to GitHub with the required changes that you have made inside your app. So now what you will see, if you refresh your Heroku app, it will automatically make those changes. And now if I refresh, let me just see, guys, inside our, if you open your source folder, and if you go to your app.vue file, you will see this change. Welcome to Vue test app made by Gautam. But why it is not reflects? Oh, sorry. I have, now let me refresh this. Every push to master will deploy a new version of this app. Deploys happen automatically. Be sure that this branch is always in. So let me just see, guys, overview section. Let me open this app from here. Now, guys, I will show you in the last process, there was some kind of error. That is why I was not able to show you. Now it is working. So now if you make any sort of change inside your file, let's suppose I change this to, this is made by John, and I add some more here. And now let me commit these changes like this. Commit. This is my fourth commit. So I will write here fourth commit. But before that, I need to add all this. So git add dash, and then I need to, this is my fourth commit. And after this, you can see the one file is changed. Now we need to push these changes to GitHub. So it will have this command git push dash f origin master. So now what you will see, as this command is successful, automatically this in this Heroku dashboard, it will build out the app. The build process will start automatically. So just wait. Here inside this latest activity tab, it will automatically trigger those changes. So just wait, it is, you can see, build in process. So if you go to the activity tab, it will show you all these processes. If you click on view build process, it will show your app is building here. You can see that it is installing the dependencies again here. And now let me just show you where is my GitHub. So if I refresh here, you will see I have made these changes. That is why it is triggering those changes. That is Heroku. So just wait, it is building it for the production. So you can see, just wait. So after the build process is successful, then you can open this app from this button. So you can see that, just wait. So build in progress. So when the build process is completed, this green text will be there, that is build succeeded. And now you can see that build succeeded message is there and it is successfully deployed. If I open this app, now you will see the required changes. Welcome to view test app made by John. The same changes that I made inside my Visual Studio Code. So in this easy way, you can auto deploy your Vue.js app inside Heroku with the help of GitHub. Thanks very much guys for watching this video. You can go to the video description to follow the step-by-step instruction that I have given with commands and screenshot my blog post. Please like the video, share the video, and I will be seeing you in the next video. Until then, thank you very much.